So, from a side view, it looks like yay. This is the table. And this is the crown. And this is the pavilion. And this is the girdle. And then some of them are cut at the bottom or some of them are pointed. Okay, so now but we're looking straight down on it like this. So it's got two kind of boxes. And when I get photographs of it, even if it's just really straight on, it's never going to be perfect. There's always weird angles and these little reflections that come in that are not geometric, which is kind of interesting. Okay, so there's one box, and there's another box on top of it.
When you photograph, do you just use like a regular?
I use photographs from catalogs and magazines.
Oh.
I don't take the photographs.
Oh, okay.
I'm not really a realist because there are I'm going to call them illustrators, and they're going to do actual real drawings of jewels. Also, jewelry designers, they're going to draw, more analytically, where I'm just trying to give an essence. I'm just trying to get brilliance on a flat canvas any way I can. So I'm not really mathematical. Although it really helps me to do this, knowing the mathematics of this. The more you know about your subject, the better you are going to be at drawing it, no matter what it is. Okay, see these are like triangle, these are facets. This right here is this table up here. And then these right here are these facets. And there's 58 of them. And there's a lot of facets down in this section, too. All right, then this would like, for instance, to the outside of the gem would just continue on. This would continue on this way. This would continue on this way. This. But now, in reality, in the photograph, some of these might disappear. But again, I'm doing kind of more of an analytical version. Mm-hmm. An illustrator would use a straight edge on that. Okay, now, classically, always the light comes in. The good guys are always on the left, from any movie. The good guys always come in from the left. The bad guys come in from the right. So any classical picture is, it's going to be lit from this side. And the shadow is going to be over there. And every one of those that I show you is the same thing. And I kind of, emphasize it too. But they're usually basically always lit this way. So the light's being shot from this angle. So this is the shadow area, and this is the light area. So this thing right here is the table. So there's dimension. It goes back in space. So if the light's hitting it, that this is on the inside. This is going to have shadow in here. This is going to be really hot light up here. This is going to be in shadow down here. This is going to be shadow down here. So in order to give you dimension, you're going to kind of give it a shadow area. However you guys do shadows. Some people do cross-hatching like this. Some people do shadowing and then they mush it with their finger, But it's dark. It's a dark tone against white. Because your brilliance on your white paper is the white paper. So remember this is going to have some depth in it down here. And then these are going to have some shadows down here.